That's an old one.
Yeah. So.
We have a lot. I mean, I know over the years we gave you a whole bunch of new life.
You see what you say there? Over the years.
It's true.
That's it.
Yeah. Ace, what's going on, bud?
What's up, ladies and gentlemen? Welcome back to Over the Years. I'm here with my guy, my buddy, my dog, Mr. Ace of Base. Mr. Ace of Base. Isn't that right, boo-boo? Oh, he's taking up his position now. He's gonna lay down and relax, huh, boo-boo? Hey, boo-boo. Say hi to the people on YouTube. Ladies and gentlemen, it's Saturday. We're getting ready to go yard sailing. Believe it or not, we're still not completely in yard sale season. It's kind of like spring training. So we're going to go out here. We're going to try and, you know, get some dust off and hopefully find some stuff at least. We got two yard sales that we're going to be going to today. So we're going to go ahead and check those out. Hopefully, you never know what you're going to find. But it is good to get the feet wet again because yard sale season will be coming sooner rather than later, hopefully. The flea markets, one of the flea markets that we go has its opening weekend, and that is coming up this upcoming weekend. So we'll be going there, but for now, let's go ahead and head out and go to these yard sales and see what we can find. If this is your first time here, make sure you guys subscribe. Shout out to all the new subscribers. You guys seem to really like that milk glass video. If you have any other videos you want to see us do, drop a comment in the comment section below. But let's grab the keys and head on out and go to the yard sales. See you guys out there. All right, ladies and gentlemen. Oh, it feels so good to be out at a yard sale. Weather has not been too kind as of late, so when I did see these yard sales pop up, I said, you know what, I gotta go. The ad on this yard sale actually said almost everything was $1. It said it had hats and sports cards and video games. So I said, you know what? Might as well go ahead and take a little peek. So I walked right up to the hat bucket. There was some hats in here, not a lot. I ended up buying two hats, one of which was this sort of vintage navy hats. These usually do really well for me. I already got this one up and listed. I try to get everything listed that I picked up already from this these two yard sales. But the second hat I grabbed, the snap was actually broken. So I ended up taking the patch off and just keeping the patch. There was a bunch of cards here, but it was all like junk wax era. Nothing really that was even something that I could probably remotely find some value for. This, if you guys aren't aware, I do have a sports channel, Over the Years Sports. You guys want to go ahead and go over there and subscribe, that would be dope. But yeah, I tried to kind of look through some things, but I got an idea pretty quick of what was actually in these boxes and decided that there was nothing really of interest to me or had much value for me to be able to flip, whether on one of my whatnot shows or listing on eBay or one stop shop. So also video games, I would imagine somebody probably got here before me and just cleaned out all those other games. Just weren't really anything that I wanted to spend time on listing. Wasn't a lot of profit there as well. I did see this Fiesta ware over there in the box. I thought about it, but that sort of stuff, it sits unless it's a really rare color or a really rare piece. So I ended up not even dabbling into the Fiesta ware. I did realize that it looked like there was two different families set up at this yard sale.
How you doing?
How you doing, sir?
Good, how about yourself, boss? How much are the Georgetown jerseys?
Those are brand new, real deal, so I'm trying to get at least 20
of them. I feel you.
Fortunately, the Georgetown jerseys were about $20 a piece. Definitely no room there for me to make any profit. So I decided to pass on the Georgetown basketball jerseys. So we came over here to a couple of totes. Now, this is not something I usually dive into. I don't do a lot of plush, don't do a lot of dolls, but you know, this is spring training. So I'm learning, trying to, you know, see what else I can find. I ended up buying this Cabbage Patch doll included with my bundle of stuff. It ended up being a fake doll, but I did take the clothes off of that Cabbage Patch doll and I switched it onto the real Cabbage Patch doll that I bought. So I took the outfit off of this one and put that outfit on this one. Already got it up and listed. But like I said, I didn't really know a lot about Cabbage Patch dolls. I ended up finding a dope video by my buddy Kevin the Commonwealth Picker featuring the Daily Cabbage. So I learned a lot after this yard sale. I also picked up this Alf puppet plush and a Winnie the Pooh puppet plush. A lot of this plush was puppets. So I did end up comping a lot of stuff and didn't really find anything that I thought had much value. So I passed on a lot of that stuff. But every single item that I ended up picking up here at this yard sale was only $1 a piece. So for me, it was totally worth it to kind of learn some new things. You know, post some of that stuff online. If it doesn't sell fast, then I'll just put it in a live sale either on Whatnot or on one of the districts that I am a member of. So it turned out to be okay for me.
All right, ma'am. I think I'm all set. One, two, three, four, five, six.
This couple was actually super nice, very, very cool people. Unfortunately, the music was cranking, which I love, but I couldn't include the conversation because of music. But they were actually eBay sellers. They recognized me from one of the video they saw me in with Commonwealth Picker. So they were getting rid of a lot of their eBay inventory at this sale, which is why everything was in those plastic bags and had SKU numbers on them. I didn't realize it until they mentioned it to me, but very nice couple. Shout out to them. If you guys see this video, thank you very much. I appreciate the good conversation. And then, yeah, we packed everything up in this big bag, and then we are gonna load up the car and make our way on to the next stop. So
thank you both very much. Y'all have a great one. All right,
all right, here we go. Yard sale number two. See the sun shining. It feels good to be back out on the yard sale trail. We did peep that beer mirror when we first walked up. I made a mistake here. If you see something that you like, pick it up. And then if you decide that you don't want it later, go put it back. Because I could have easily missed that and somebody else could have walked up behind me and grabbed it. I did check out and see if there's anything interested in the DVD stack or the CD box. Nothing really stood out to me. You know, I'm kind of just flipping things over. We made a video about this once before where it's important to kind of flip everything over, see what markings are on the bottom. If anything sticks out to you, you know, maybe put it aside and you can kind of comp it. So definitely always flip items over.
Morning.
How are you doing today?
Good. How are you?
Hanging in.
Good. You a YouTuber?
Yes, ma'am.
I see your. What's your channel?
Over the Years. You like to watch the yard sale videos?
I do
too.
What was it? Homeschool Picker. And,
yeah.
Yep. When I saw your GoPro there, I was like, okay.
One of the first things that we flipped over that we kept was this Furstenberg vase made in Western Germany.
She's nice.
I'm trying to think of the other one. Commonwealth Picker, but he just changed his name, didn't he?
Well, no, he's got two different channels, Commonwealth Picker and Commonwealth Flipper.
The other one, it's
88. Oh, Dave, yeah. Kevin's a really great guy. Commonwealth Picker, he's...
Yeah, he seems like it.
Yeah, he's absolutely stand-up guy, like, just...
Seems like it.
Family is so much fun. They're super nice. Like, just everything you would want when you meet somebody like that, that you, like, invest time in watching. Right. So he's a good friend of mine now.
Oh, good.
I actually live in D.C., but I grew up not too far from here. I went to Einstein.
Oh, so did I.
Yeah, so.
You graduated in 87.
Okay.
Einstein.
Yes, ma'am. I graduated in 2002.
Ah, okay.
Yeah, you might Youngin. Know some of our friends' kids.
I did notice that he had a GoPro on, so he's like the people that I watch that do the Commonwealth Pictures and stuff to go around. buy and resell. And he knows the guys that I watch. So we're probably going to be on YouTube.
Yeah.
Unless we say don't do it.
Wave to the camera.
We don't care.
As long as you don't put our name with it.
No, you're good. You're good. Don't worry.
And we're open to offers. I don't want to have to pack anything back.
I know. I know the feeling.
And more than half of it's gone already, which is awesome. Yeah.
That's always
early people.
That's a plus, yeah.
Are there any sales out there today?
No.
It's a great day for it.
I know.
It was half and half because I figured, a lot of people might already be away for the holiday.
True.
No, I think a lot of people like me are itching, you know? Because around here it's been, you know, like...
the weather.
Yeah. So they're just like, just get warm so I can go yard selling every single weekend. Good. So.
It's fun.
Yeah, let's get us started.
Yep. So a lot of the stuff that we picked up was not very high dollar stuff, but Ainsley is a really good name to look out for. So that's one of the things that we kept was that Ainsley piece. We picked up the pottery vase and we picked up the Western Germany vase as well. And then we came back to the beer mirror and looked it up. It did have some value. You got to be careful with beer mirrors, though. You will see a lot of fluctuation in pricing. This one has sold for as low as $25, $30. And it has sold as high as $100, as you can see from the comp on the screen. So I ended up picking it up. I try not to buy too many beer mirrors because they can be big to store and can at times be a pain to ship. But this one was a good enough size where I felt comfortable given the price and the amount of work it's going to take for me to ship something like that. So I did end up grabbing the beer mirror, and I think it will turn out to be a good pickup with some good profit in the end. So I was happy with that grab.
So we got that.
What do you want for those, Amy?
Oh.
Two and one.
Yeah, so five.
Got it.
Yep, and I'll wrap
Thank
them up.
Thank you very much, man. All right, sounds good, bud. Appreciate you. All right, so it's five and five?
Yep.
All right. Thank you, ladies, very much.
All right,
I appreciate you.
You
all enjoy the rest of your day. Thank you, ma'am.
Yep.
If you see
all those pictures out there.
Yeah, if you subscribe to the channel and you watch a video, drop a comment. Say hello.
What is yours again?
Over the years.
All right,
you ladies take care.
We have some more beer signs if you're interested. Is that the kind of thing you want?
I mean, this one just kind of stood out to me.
That's an old one.
Yeah, so you see what you say there? Over the years?
It's true.
That's it?
Yep.
Yes, ma'am. Y'all take care now.
Okay. All right, ladies and gentlemen, we are back from yard sailing. Appreciate everybody hanging out with us during those two yard sales. Not a lot of crazy stuff. We did find some cool items. Some items that we think we'll be able to sell in some of our live auctions or should sell quickly. But we did use those things that we bought as opportunity to learn some. Especially about the Cabbage Patch dolls. That's a whole nother world. And I was kind of interested in, you know, learning about it. And luckily there was a great video by my guy, Commonwealth Picker. And I was able to kind of, you know, now I know what to look for if I ever come across Cabbage Patch dolls. So that's part of the game, ladies and gentlemen, is always learning. The more you learn, the more you earn. You know what I'm saying? So if you guys aren't subscribed to the Reseller Information Network, make sure you guys check us out. We go live every Tuesday, and then we put out a pre-recorded video every Friday talking about, you know, tips and tricks and helping each other and always learning new things and teaching others. So it's a lot of fun. So if you guys aren't subscribed to that, make sure you subscribe to that. We do have two live sales coming up. Both of them are going to be on Crazy Lamp Ladies Marketplace Knickknacks. We will put the links for each one of those shows in the description. One of those shows is Sunday, April 7th, and I think the next one is April 10th. So make sure you guys go ahead and check those out. We'll be selling a bunch of vintage glass, some ceramics, and some figurines. It'll be a lot of fun, so hopefully we'll see you guys there. Hopefully you all enjoyed this video. We will be going to the flea market this weekend, so we're kind of super excited about that, and hopefully we'll get some footage and put out a video for you guys to enjoy. Don't forget, if there's any videos you want us to make, drop a comment below, and we'll see what we can do as far as making those videos for you, because this is not about me, this is about you. Appreciate all the love and all support. Hit the thumbs up, don't forget to subscribe, but most importantly, stay classy, YouTube. Peace!